are here to expose these things to you. I want to tell you that all the marriage conducted in United States, London and the white country is fake. Before your marriage can be legalized, you have to be the parent of the woman. It doesn't actually mean that you have to celebrate anything. For their breasts, their things, they might ask from you. You have to pay a dowry. Compulsory. Even in the beginning of Adam and Eve, the Bible said, and God hand over Eve to Adam. Any marriage, even though you are in Africa, that you do, and the parent of the woman is not approving it, sir, is a fake wedding. If the mother is absenting and the father is not accepting, yes, I don't go ahead. Think well before you do things. The journey to heaven is not a side play. No, be where you feel good, Papa House. You can't use money to buy heaven. You cannot bribe God with your prayers. You can't bribe Him with your praises. You can't bribe God with your services. You can't bribe God with your finances. Your support.
For this precious money, my name is Apostle Peter Daniel. By the grace of God, you are watching me in Heaven and Hell Live program. The Lord be with you in Jesus' mighty name. Today we are going to be talking on a topic called illegal marriage in the Western regions, in the white countries. Illegal marriage and the legality of marriage in the place. Let's quickly pray. Let's pray. Our Lord and our God, we thank you for this hour. We ask you to open our eyes to see the truth of your word. Opens our heart to accept your word. We ask you, Lord, to make this message go round so that the white people can be saved. In Jesus' name, amen. As I've said before, I will not take your time. It's just a short message. The Lord said I should tell you some things, and that is why I am here to tell you. I'm going to speak on the marriage that is being conducted in the white regions, the white countries. I want to let you know that all the Christians that is there right now, if you are in the white country right now, and you are following their rules accordingly, you are on your way to hell. I am not here to make, I've said it before, I won't take your time, I won't take much time. I just here to tell you the word of God. If you are in the white country right now and you are following their rules, you are on your way to hell. Because white country gets their rules from the satanic covens, from the Freemasons and Illuminatis. The Freemasons caught. That is where they get their rules. And if you are following it, you are on your way to hell. Going back to the message I want to talk about, I want to tell you that all the marriage conducted in United States, London and the white country is fake. If you are with a woman now, in your house, and you got married in a white country there, And the marriage you marry, you know, in the white country, they will tell you that if you want to go to court, you and the man will just go to court, they join together, and the marriage begin. You call it a contract. If you are part of Christians that go to court without the parent of the woman and the parent of the man, you are on your way to hell. The Bible says that let the parent of the woman be the one to hand over her to you. You see, the one the court did for you and tell you we join you together today, and they sign and sign, is fake one. Before your marriage can be legalized, it has to be the parent of the woman. It doesn't actually mean that you have to celebrate anything. But they are pressed, there are things they might ask from you. You have to pay a dowry compulsorily. The mother, the father have to hand over her to you in blessing. And that is marriage. Even in the beginning of Adam and Eve, the Bible said, and God hand over Eve to Adam. God represents the father of Adam, of Eve and Adam. And it's okay, oh, come here, the Eve come. He said, this is the woman for you. And Adam said, this is the bone of my bone. So if the marriage you married, if the parent of that girl, of that lady, you know, in the white country there, you just get any woman, you agree together, you go to court, you say you have married, and you say you are married, you are on your way to hell, sir. Ma, you are on your way to hell. But that is how they do it here in the country. Are you not saying that all the people, all the white people there, they are all going to hell? Yes, if they did the same thing, they are all going to hell. Listen to me. Do you think God really think as you think? Do you actually think that the way you reason is the way God reasons? Do you think that God look at multitude? Do you know how many people that is already in heaven right now? You are just an addition. You are just a dara, a addition to those who are in heaven. Do you know how many souls that are already in heaven as we're talking now? You think you say there are thousands? No, answer me. You think you say there are thousands? Do you know how many people who resurrected with Jesus Christ on that day? When he resurrected on from death? Do you know how many souls who came back to life with him? Do you know how many angels that are already there? Since that time to this moment, do you know how many people who have been making heaven? If you don't go to heaven, there are people there. It's for your own personal benefit to make it to heaven. It's not God's own benefit. It's you. God is not losing. God is not a failure. He has people there. It's just because of his mercy. His mercy. It's just like a parent that have a lot of children. The parent will never wish that one of them die. That's the point. That's all. That's what is happening. But he has them all. The question I want to be said, but God is still loving, as you supposed, you thought. God is loving, and God sent rain and destroyed the whole world. God is loving, and God distressed Sodom and Gomorrah. That sense alone should tell you God is loving, and God told Israel to go and kill his enemy. I didn't say God is not loving. He's loving. But don't mess up with him. Don't mess up with him with your actions and your behaviors. Don't mess up with him. If you mess up with him, you will cry. If you mess up with him, you will cry. I tell you. You will cry. Don't mess up with him. Who do you even call God? Tell me. Who do you call him? Who do you even call God? No, let me know. You go to a court. One person will now stand and say, I join you together. Who are you? Who are you? Who gave you authority to join two people together? Who gave you? Who are you? Illegally? That's why the wrath of God is so heavy in the white country. And those who desire to drink the milk of the people who are in the white country, those who desire to drink the milk in Babylon, in the white country, they will also suffer with them. I tell you, it's the message of God. It's not of man. All what I have to do is to tell you the message. And to warn you against God in judgment. The right marriage when Abraham wanted to get wife for his sons, he sent the servant to the wife house of that woman, and the servant go there, he present them the gift, and the parents, those who were standing, the parents of that young lady, they ask her, are you willing to marry the man they want to marry? He said yes. He followed. He said yes. He said okay. And they blessed them. When the same couple, Isaac and his wife, they grew up and they gave birth, the son of covenant, which is Jacob, called Israel, when he went to get his wife, he suffered to pay the dowry for good 14 years for the two of them that he married. He suffered to pay the dowries. And he paid it. Look at them, the way they are marrying people there. It's their parents that gave them to her, to him. The parent of the woman is the most important part. Even though your parent, as a man's parent, is not really there. But you told them and they agreed. Fine. But the parent of the woman, the parent, if the parent said no, it's no. If you by force and marry her, you will be in trouble. You will end up in hell, I tell you. If the parent of the guest said no, sir, nothing you can do in heaven and earth. She will not go to wife and they will say you don't do contract of marriage. They say you married people, two people together. There are even some people that were there because of money, because of green card, whatever they call that. They are marrying with good people, doing contract with them, and you call yourself a Christian. You are not a Christian. You are a bastard. If they are mentioning Christian, don't ever raise up your hands. You are a bastard to the kingdom of God. You are a bastard. You sold your birthright. You sold the salvation just because of green card. Just because of green card. You sold it. You not think God is a fool. Where are you going to heaven? You are deceiving yourself. You can't go there. You can't make it there. He won't accept you. Is it not God? He won't accept it. He won't. I tell you. I pray you make it to heaven. Any marriage, even though you are in Africa, that you do, and the parent of the woman is not approving it, sir, it's a fake wedding. If the mother is accepting and the father is not accepting, don't go ahead. Oh God. Don't go ahead. The both party has to accept. The both party. They have to accept it. Otherwise, you are in trouble. Especially the father of the girl. If the mother is still doing something, the father can go.
If the father is not alive, let the mother approve it. If the mother is not alive, and the both of them is not alive, he must have somebody that is standing as his family, that is standing as his father now. Like somebody who is seen as his father, who is playing a role as a father in her life, the person should approve it. Otherwise, the marriage is illegal. Any wedding you do, that you both do for you, the wife will do for you, you are, it's a fake. You have to do it according to the way the Bible. I want to even ask you, who bring white wedding? Is it the Bible? Is white wedding in the Bible? I'm asking you, is white wedding in the Bible? Why do you bring white wedding? You two were dancing to it. In fact, you will meet yourself in the judgment room. That is the message I want to tell you today. Think well. Think well before you do things. The journey to heaven is not a side play. Not be where you feel go, Papa House. You can't use money to buy heaven. You cannot bribe God with your prayers. You can't bribe him with your praises. You can't bribe God with your services. You can't bribe God with your finances, your support. You can't bribe God. You have to do the right thing. Otherwise, you are on your way to hell. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Please share this message. It's short. Share it to everywhere. Don't hide it. Let somebody hear it and get saved. Subscribe to this channel and press notification button. My name remains Apostle Peter Daniel. God bless you and God be with you. Shalom.